wouldn't give it as high a grade here in the second half. They've become much more involved and much more part of the story, and there have been very few officiating issues here this week. So here's Mitchell at the free throw line in his first year at West Virginia University, the junior college transfer. 12 out of 15 free throws. Doesn't get there a lot. He's more of a perimeter player.
Imagine you shot 15 free throws all season, and now you're there
to this?
In this circumstance.
And nothing but nylon, huh? Goodness.
Big and he comes right back out. Thurman in. Looks like they're going to extend the 1-3-1.
A lot of driving area for Wright.
Into the corner for Freeman. Trying to drive. Shut off by Thurman.
Pretty.
For the tie. Good for Austin Freeman. There's the team doctor who's been monitoring his health and well-being as he adjusts to life as a diabetic. Dr. Stephen Clement, an important part of that Georgetown sideline. You wondered earlier if Freeman was battling fatigue, but he's one of the best players in the country, and he has risen to the occasion late here for Georgetown.
And the dribble does it, Sean. Drive, draw, kick, and some early onions by a healthy Freeman.
But how about the way he goes against the grain? He goes against the grain of the drive. That is really hard to guard. Great job by Austin Freeman.
And how about them putting those two on the same size consistently? And then you got the option of getting the lane to getting Clark going.
Georgetown even. For the first time since it was 13 apiece with 10:46 left in the first half. Another tight one. And it's only fitting because the regular season featured one seat squirmer after another. I mean, Marquette was kind of the poster child for that. So here they come.
Mitchell back into the game for offense.
24 to shoot. And they shoot early out of the corner. And it comes back to Butler after it was well defended originally by Benjamin. The shot clock is off now. West Virginia can take it all the way down if they want. And a foul.
Didn't have to.
No, you wonder if Wright thought they were behind. I think he misunderstood what the bench was saying to him. I think he thought they were behind.
Why would he foul with a tie game?
I think he thought they were behind.
Yeah. How could he think that?
But why else would he do it?
I don't know. But I mean, you just had a timeout.
Well, he looked over to the sideline.
Look at that. You're right, Sean.
Pointed toward the scoreboard. Yeah. I don't think he understood the situation. Incredible. Two shots for Missoula.
How about this kid?
46% for the year. But as we mentioned, that's deceiving because of the shoulder problems. He came in having made 7 of the last 9.
Wright's got to shake it.
5 for 5 from the line tonight.
Wright's got to shake it off. Move on to the next thing.
How about man-to-man this trip, Jay? The 1-3-1, they've been able to do some things. They extend the floor. Huggins got a change looking.
Huggins bemoaning lack of shooting during the year, but they've made 14 free throws in a row now. 2-tie, 3-for-lead. Wright ties it up.
Way to go, kid. Way to bounce back.
Butler's pass deflected. Missoula in traffic. Got it off. 9 seconds to go, and finally they'll use the timeout. Bob Huggins looked like he wanted to let them play, but then it was such a scramble that West Virginia has used this last timeout. 9 seconds to go, tied at 58.
Well, a moment ago, Jay, he wasn't sure. He was sure on the offensive end. Chris taking it right at the defense. This is power. You talked about his explosion. How about that little kiss? Good for you, young guy. Well, that's pretty. The drop step, pretty good D as well. Hang in there. And
well, here go the Mountaineers again in another tight one Thursday night with a game tied against Cincinnati. The Butler did it with the bank shot, breaking a 51-51 tie. Deion Dixon, who had lost the ball out of bounds seconds before, agonized. And then last night, West Virginia up by two. Torrey Jackson had a look at a three with 5 seconds to go. And then Wellington Smith, a nice strip in the rebounding action. West Virginia held on again. So two narrow victories. Will they dance with the Big East title tonight? Deshaun Butler clearly where they want to go. He's hit 5 game-winning shots in the final seconds this year for West Virginia.
And the ball being inbounded from the exact same spot it was in the Cincinnati game for the last shot. Deshaun Butler will be in the same spot. They'll run Casey Mitchell into the corner to drag a defender there.
West Virginia hasn't had a field goal in 7 minutes, 16 seconds. All their 8 points, the most recent 8 from the line.
And nobody on the ball again.
Ebanks inbounds it to Butler. Butler into the lane. In the traffic. It goes again for Butler. 4 seconds to go. They have a timeout. Right down by 2. Scoops it up. No. West Virginia has won its first Big East championship.
Going to touch it, Jay.
But nobody guards the ball to make the catch more difficult. And just an unbelievable shot. Everybody knew it was going to Butler, and they got it to him anyway.
And look at this, almost getting wire to wire. How many times in a career? Same play. No bank this time. Just perseverance.
But, Bill, if you've got somebody guarding the ball, that is not as easy a pass. You can disrupt it.
Seems to happen a lot lately. So some today.
Kevin Jones and the native New Yorkers so emotional they return home to New York City, the Madison Square Garden, and win the first Big East championship in the million throughout the 4 nights. Georgetown denied in a bid to add to its record total of Big East titles. They're still at 7. Deshaun Butler said, Bob Huggins says, if you want to be special, you have to do something special. This was their opportunity tonight, and they win the first conference championship in tournament play for the school since they won the Atlantic 10 way back in 1984. Decisions ever in conference tournament history. Deshaun Butler is the most outstanding player of this Big East championship. He'll win the Dave Gavitt Trophy. And he's one of Bob Huggins' favorite players. Bob said not only is he perhaps the most complete player ever coached, he's as good a person as I have coached. And you can see the emotion in Huggs. And here's Doris.
Coach, congratulations. You won a lot of championships in a lot of different conferences, but it's Saturday night in New York in the Big East. Characterize what this win means to you.
Well, this is very special for me because it's West Virginia. And these guys are unbelievable. I mean, we continue to compete and fight and rebound the ball and do things that probably we shouldn't be able to do, but we do anyway.
You had so many guys do so many things. Wellington Smith, Joe Mazzulla. But yet again, the Butler delivers. I'll ask you again, what allows this young man to continue to shine in the toughest moments?
Like I told you last time, whoever didn't know the ball's going to be in his hands hasn't watched us. We're going to give him the ball and let him make a play.
Can you describe the job that Wellington Smith did defensively? Everybody's going to want to talk about his points and his rebounds, but describe the effort he gave you defensively.
He did. He kept the ball alive so many times for us. And when we were struggling to score, he rebounded the ball for us and did a great job guarding their bigs.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you, Doris.
Deshaun, the ball finds its way to you yet again in the moment that matters most. Just evaluate tell me what was going through your mind when you catch it that late.
I knew it was tied, and I had a good feeling they thought I was going to shoot a three. So I got a little hesitation in there, and went to the basket, and Austin stepped up, and I tried to, like, get a little hop step over him, and I got it up in time, and then went in. Evan made a big shot. I thought I made a big shot, so I told him I was going to make another one. Then there you go. So.
Coach talks about doing special things. You have to do that to do it. Tell me, from your perspective, a New Yorker and so many of your teammates from this area, to win it in Madison Square Garden where you watch your beloved Knicks, what does it mean to you?
It means the world to me. You know, I grew up around this area, man. I played against pretty much every basketball player from this area in New Jersey. This is my favorite team, the New York Knicks. This is my team. I grew up watching this on television. I grew up playing here pretty much. And I've played so well here since I've been a freshman throughout my career. So, you know, it means so much to me just to get our state's first, our school's first biggest championship. You know, it means the world to me, honestly.
Congratulations. Go celebrate with your guys.
Much. I appreciate it.
Sean.
One of the great players in the history of West Virginia basketball, a fitting accomplishment for an ultimate team player. For those who think Bob Huggins is just one big tough guy, you can hear the emotion in his voice, too.
And on the final play, Sean, nobody guarding the ball. If you are right there guarding the ball instead of right here, you can affect the angle of the pass, and perhaps Deshaun Butler doesn't catch it so easily. And once he catches it, you really are only guarding it with one guy. Well, one man on Butler has proven not to be enough, Bill.
How about the follow-through here? He didn't have total control, Jay. Able to armpit it back home, and this kid just steps up at the right moment. Let's give him a little onions at the end of the year. Wow, what a way to finish. Great defense, offensive rebounding, but when it comes to clutch time, wow, that kid steps up.
Georgetown had a timeout, but they elected to go without it, and they got a great look from Chris Wright. He just didn't make it. For all the day's action and more on this game, stay tuned for SportsCenter. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. What a week it has been here at the Big East Championship. Jay Billis, Bill Raftery, Doris Burke, and our entire crew, Sean McDonough, saying congratulations to West Virginia, the 2010 Big East champions. Good night, everyone. This